Jarvis Landry is the fire starter.
When they need to get going, number 80 is the guy that really gives the energy to the Cleveland Browns.
That shit is like weird to see a game on Sunday without Juice not being on the field. How does a player not miss a game in his first 7 years?
Like, I want to be out there so bad. I never really knew what that feeling felt like.
I miss it. There's no place I'd rather be. If you have that feeling, then you're truly doing what God has put you on this earth to do.
Rolls Royce swerving, famous bitch curving, seeing you out in traffic, you was looking nervous.
You guys got the game plan for the weekend yet?
I don't know if we're trying to throw the shit out the ball, but we got some runs in.
I feel like every time you think you're gonna throw, you guys run, and every time you guys think you're gonna run, you guys throw.
Yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen, but it looked like they want to throw the ball a lot. We got a lot of pass plays.
I should have popped before I went back.
Big sit up.
Oh, yes.
Deep breath in. And out.
There we go.
And hazard. That's what you needed. That's what you needed. That's the SI joints right there. Any passes?
One.
You got passes this game?
Yeah. I threw. It's supposed to go back to the running back.
Chubb or Hunt?
Kareem.
Whoever's in.
Kareem.
Deep breath in.
I felt like I had one of the best off seasons that I've had in a long time. Whether I was hurt, whether location, you know, facility, the type of work that I was doing. So I felt this year I had got, you know, I was able to put a full year together. I mean, I took like 2 weeks off after the season, you know, so like I had more time, you know, I wasn't rehabbing. You know, I still had some rehab things in there because I had more time to do, but I just felt like, you know, I put in a lot of work and pretty much.
Practice his whole life. Are you willing to put in that sort of commitment? Are you willing to practice your whole life? Sure you want to be on a jet and all that, but do you want to put in that work? That's what it takes for something great, that amount of time, that level of commitment. You know what I mean?
So, I mean, this joint, little cotton base. We was at the crib, just talking about what we was gonna do for the season. So, man, let's do something different. Like, something ain't no one ever really done before. You know what I mean? So, came up with this joint, sitting at the couch, came on over. He was like, man, let's do some blue. I was like, all right, say no more. I like the blue. Waited like a few days, sent me back. Was like, man, let's wear this with like nothing on under. Like, let's, you know what I'm saying? Just don't put nothing on, no shirt, no button up, just the taco meat. You know what I'm saying? And let the tattoos and little chains show a little bit. Why not? So that's how this came into fruition. What's fun about this has never been done before. A lot of people see like a straight line that comes down from the top seam all the way down to the pants, but something like this, the intricate, man, that shit was hard to do. He dresses what fits him. You know what I'm saying? Like, he don't try to be someone else. He goes with what he's comfortable with. He goes with what fits him, his style, and what he, overall, like I said, he's comfortable with more than anything. So for me, that's what makes it fun. And when someone at times will hit you with like, yo, let's do this, let's do that, I'm like, all right, bet, let's go out the box. Like this here, this is out the box. How are you living?
I was like, damn, man, that's the one thing I forgot. I ain't had a bag that matched.
I'm throwing this shit out, man. I was like, bro, I don't even want this shit, bro. Look. Bro, hell
no. Oh, I was going back in that bitch. Oh, y'all gotta get me right.
And I drunk
some of this. And I done got sick as a motherfucker.
I was like, I ain't even wanna walk back after that. I was like, bro, I don't even.
I was gonna get my lawsuit.
Bro, I put that shit all on Yelp, though. So I was like, man.
Yelp?
Man, yeah.
Fuck, bitch, are you 50 years old or something?
Oh, bro, that shit a bigger effect. That shit affect more than anything.
Man, that shit don't touch me.
Man, nothing. You crazy.
Nigga said, Yelp.
Yeah, bro. Bro, did you hear the fire alarm here in the bit?
Man, they did that shit on purpose.
That's what I said. That's what I told my girl, bro. I told you. I said, Lou. I was like, bro, they probably did that shit on purpose. Lou ain't even hear that bit.
What's up, boy? What's up? Ooh, come step on them niggas, man.
Oh, man.
Step on them.
You suited and booted, though.
Mm-mm.
No, I don't want no smoke.
Oh, yeah,
no, your shit was dummy too.
That shit threw
us off.
Yeah,
and you know we in Missouri.
Yeah, that shit in the middle. So
that's like, what he just.
You don't know where, like what side is on. Me. It's on both sides. Yeah,
I ain't know that shit. I'm over brushing my teeth. Like, yeah, you know we in Missouri. What? Like, nah, but then we gotta go to Kansas. What? I told Lou, I was like, this shit like some yogurt. I was like, all right, let me shake that hoe up. Open that bitch up.
You crazy.
Bro.
You supposed to go back in.
But I ain't. I'm saying.
You supposed to go back right now.
I ain't gonna go back. Nah, bro.
Oh, I never left Kansas. This should have been your state right here.
That's what
Missouri.
He said.
I never left. Never. I'd have been right in Missouri. You crazy. Man.
What? Hey, I ain't feel like going back. We
that's
already
a hazard.
What that nigga say? Nigga talking about he don't want, He left a Yelp review.
Yeah.
Bro, that's somebody else gonna go do the same thing you did. Buying that shit gonna be rich. Cause you wanna play around.
Paper. Man, I see y'all boys on the flippy. Mm-hmm. Get down before they try to leave us. Thank you, brother.
Thank you, bro. I'll see you.
All right. That bitch is hard. The heart is out. The heart is. You know what I'm saying? Look good, play good, feel good. Yo, I'm on the elevator.
Okay.
That shit just stopping on other floors, I guess, but I'm on the elevator.
Okay.
All right.
You see that OG?
Go! The best thing we can do this year is we're going to get the ball out into the flat because we got the offensive line that can do that. We're going to get that screen pass going to Clyde Edwards-Helaire. It is going to be a great, great game. I look forward to the challenge of playing the Browns.
It was fun, bro. Like, you know, it was definitely a feeling that I had missed, you know, being that fans hadn't been in the stadium and stuff like that. And then obviously I still felt like it was a game and like, okay, to see all the things that I did in the offseason kind of come to life against like another good team, like a championship team. They've been to the championship for the last 2 years. So it's like it's a good bar, like, you know, to see where you're at, you know? And I felt that's, you know, I felt like I was ready.
When they hand it off, a They trick him a little bit. The inside handoff, and that's Landry. Oh, twice rotating around, and they're gonna spot him down.
No, that was a play that all week that was really designed for someone else. And then coach was like, you know what, man? I just know that if I give it to you, I don't have no worries about like if we're gonna get the first down. You know, we really just wanted the first down, but we called it in a goal line situation. And once I got past the first down, then I was like, shit, I may as well score. You know what I'm saying? We definitely knew we could have won the game, but we didn't. And that's the part that hurt the worst. But there's a lot of things that we did. A lot of guys stepped up. Schwartz stepped up. You know, Baker played an almost perfect game. You know what I'm saying? Kareem, Chubb. You know, the defense stepped up when they needed it. You know, when we needed it. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I think there are a lot of good takeaways. I think the best, worst part that happened was that we lost. And, but we knew, like, you know what? We're probably going to get this opportunity again. You know what I'm saying? We got 17 more games, and we might get this opportunity again. You know, for us, it was really just like, okay, put this behind us. You know, what's the next game? The next game is the biggest game. Let's focus on this game. Let's focus on what we can do this game to, you know what I'm saying, put these boys away. And that really was the only mindset, honestly.
She just wasn't up. Hold. Big toe. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. Stand up. 5, 4. Stand up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. Stand up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. Boom, switch.
Nice. Nice.
Ball.
Good. Head speed.
Ball.
There it is.
Ball. 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 Ball.
I think it's crazy though.
His balance is like, so like the one I was doing there, he had his right eye closed.
Right.
And the left one was flashing. So he can't see anything. And then when I say ball, he has to try to locate it with this eye that's flashing. And it just picks it up quick. And that gets the, one of his eyes is a little slower than his other, so it kind of brings them back up, both up to speed.
Yeah.
And we warm our bodies up before games. A lot of people aren't warming up their nervous system and their hand-eye coordination as much.
Record time today. Right back.
But this week we're going with this little set bar right here. Excuse the mess, but this little bob with some shorts. See, you can only wear shorts for some time right now when you're in Cleveland, so why not?
That's
100
a pair.
That's a good deal, though, because the socks
were
like
$190. Bro, I bring the socks is $180, no, $190. So it's almost like you get it for $100 a sock.
Yeah. I don't know, dog.
Yeah, bro.
I'm straight up.
Dog, you buy a pair of Gucci socks, them bitches $200. So nigga, if I could get six for $600, that's $100 a sock.
You spare rare.
Definitely gonna have time. Stop.
And it's right a bit open. Just vibe with that shit open.
I'm ready to move.
Ready, Freddy?
Yeah, you good. Vibe. That's fire.
Jarvis Landry.
Yes, sir.
What's happening?
What's happening, bro?
Man, not much, man. About to see y'all get this dub today.
Absolutely.
You already know.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Good to have back for you. You all set?
Thank
man?
You, bro. Have a good one. Yes, sir.
I thought he was about to say.
Pulling up the dunking on game. I thought he was about to be like, man, why you eating this dumb shit, man? For your game, man. You need to be eating something else, man. Thought you were going to order avocado toast. Hey, man, I'm sorry, dog. They made breakfast and they ain't give me none, man.
Images, niggas act hard but they innocent. Hopping in tank and move militant, yo.
Bro! Bro! Bro!
it was a little bit emotion. I think, you know, it's good to see Tyrod, it's good to see Farrell, a couple of guys that I played with, but like, bro, like I feel like I was really like so locked in to like have a big game. Like that day, what I felt that day was like my mind was just made up to like go off. Like, yeah. I wasn't thinking about nothing else. I knew the play was coming to me. I knew, at first, when I came off the field, I was just like, I was really scared. I ain't gonna lie, I was nervous because I had hurt my knee before, but like, it never felt like how it felt. And, you know, but I thought that it would go, like the pain would go away. So like, I was like trying to give it a couple plays. Like I was telling the trainers and stuff like, man, like, just give me a couple seconds, give me a couple seconds, give me a couple seconds. And then it didn't go away.
So he got hit here and his foot was planted. So hopefully it's a grade one. Obviously he strained it. But I just wanted to be grade one, grade two.
I was just trying to get down. My leg was in the ground. That nigga, like,
his head was like this.
Got hit high on this side and low on this side. So I was like this. Like,
was you trying to think about trying to go back out?
Yeah, I was trying to go out before halftime. And then I tried to do one like a, like kind of like a little jump and push to the from the left to right.
Dude,
at first I was like, man, I felt this before, like this shit gonna go away. And then that bitch.
I was watching on telling it was like this, like that bitch was like, that's what had me and the way you looked at me.
Man, you know what it felt like? It felt like I couldn't control the bottom half of my leg. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like I could probably lift my leg up, but like this part was just hanging. That's what it felt like.
I got diagnosed with a grade 2 MCL sprain. I'm not gonna lie, I never missed a game my whole life. So like, this past Sunday, like, you know, even getting ready for the game, you know what I mean? Like, see my family get ready for the game. Like, during the week, it wasn't so hard. It was hard, but it wasn't so hard. But then Sunday, it was like, I was overwhelmed. Like I was overwhelmed with emotion. Like I wanted to cry, but then like I didn't want to be like the person that was bringing the energy down in the locker room. You know what I'm saying? Like, but like I knew I didn't need to like be around in the locker room. But part of me being a leader is being around in the locker room, and I wanted to do that too. You know what I'm saying? Because nobody really, you know, we play a dangerous sport, and you know nobody probably would have ever known that I never missed a game in my life. You know what I'm saying? So like, they wouldn't think it is a big deal, in a sense, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just football, like, it's just something that happens, you know, and that's true, it is something that just happens, but, like, that's just something that has never really happened to me. So, being able to be there and actually not do anything, it sucked, to not be a part of it, to, you know, not be in my routine, to not feel like I can contribute. You know what I mean? All those things were like tough.
It's being so unsure how you're getting it done that you just kind of keep going in the hopes of figuring out the formula. Just feeling so lucky and blessed that the fear of losing it keeps you up at night.
Pulling back the curtain by myself, take a look. Hey, I'm a bar spitter, I'm a hard hitter. Yeah, I'm light skinned, but